my YouTube videos that I did were just, I mean, I always just did that as a kid. That's just what I like to do, you know, shoot around my house with my little camera and edit my videos and stuff. And no, it's such a trip, you know, to kind of be part of something like this now at this point, and to just be I can't imagine my life without acting now. You know, I mean, like I love it so much, and I just feel like I understand it, and it's what I want to just always learn about and practice. And I, you know, so it cracks me up that these little videos that I just did for fun when I was, you know, 14 led me to that. So it's really cool.
Yeah, I mean, that was always the intention that her journey would be across the three movies. That's why, you know, in the first movie, she's a mystery. We don't get to know too much about her. We wanted to kind of play her out as long as possible. I think that's important and quite brave with movies like this. You know, you don't often get that opportunity. But in the third movie, I've spoken to Wes a lot about it. We're going to kind of see her reasoning, see why. You know, she did do this for a reason. She isn't a villain. She isn't a bad character. There's a lot, many more layers to her. And when the third one, I'm really hoping we'll get to explore that some more.
Yeah, because a lot of people end this movie hating you.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, and I, you know, that's what I love about my job. I being an actor is about exploring people. And if this was just a buddy movie where everyone got on and everyone agreed with the same thing,
right,
I personally think it'd be boring. You know, you need to show the different elements of humanity. You know, it's interesting. I hope with the third one that people get to see that, like I said before, she isn't a villain. She has her reasons. She's trying to look at the bigger picture.
It's a difficult position to be in.
And she's also the only one that has her memories back, which I think a lot of people forget.
Mm.
She's the only one that really remembers what it was like to live in this world and has seen the effect of the disease from the very early stage right up until her mother dying. So, you know, that's playing on her, and that's something she can't share with anyone else.
Oh, wow. Interesting. Man, just I want to be happy. That would be my favorite, you know.
Don't worry.
Be happy. Exactly.
Perfect.
Very similar. I think at, you know, 19 and 20, my early 20s, definitely extremely similar to Brenda. Just sort of stumbling my way through interesting situations.
The Scorch.
I was actually in a place where there were sun flares. Lived in a warehouse full of junk. That actually is true. I've been very similar. I've always been incredibly independent. I grew up in the foster care system. I was emancipated at 15. I've always had a job. I've always done everything for myself. So yeah, super, super independent. I wish I had a Jorge that was like as prominent as Giancarlo and is to, you know, my character in the movie. So yeah, very independent, very tough. I think back then, extremely guarded, extremely sensitive, and now it's sort of waning as I get.
Hello, Thomas.
You know me? A lot of our friends died for us to get this far, so we can't give up.
This is about everyone Wicked's ever taken. They'll never stop. So I'm gonna stop them.
Don't you want to know why this all happened? You're so close to the truth.